All right, here we are for round three. We get to go first. This hand seems like a clear mull. We just have no creatures. Ugh. Yeah, this is not a good hand, but I think because if our opponent plays a creature, we can slip it a bunch. Okay, and we have a creature on top. Yeah, that's good. I'm kind of loath to go to five with a deck in a deck with as much internal synergies as this. Like, you really want to have a bunch of spells so that you can get your treasure cruises going and stuff like that. Spellfist activate. Unfortunate. And now we're pretty much gassed. We have to find a way to cycle these stupid slip through spaces that we have. The upside is we have a way to kill Jace with Fiery Impulse if our opponent plays a Jace. Ugh. Okay. That's not good. Guess we'll go fetch an island. Let our opponent discard. Okay. Well, we're just one mana short now on the treasure cruise. So that could be good. Could catch us up. Kind of feel like we're gonna get to rest here. Yeah, same thing. Now I feel like we have no chance to win. Unless our opponent's hand is literally seven lands. Yeah. This is the embarrassing side of this deck. When your opponent just has no creatures in play and your hand is all cards that interact with creatures. Like, I'm gonna definitely expedite this Kalidus. We just need some action. I guess I should have fetched first, probably. I'm actually gonna get the blue land because we're gonna cast all these stupid slips. Oh man, this Kalidus will never know what hit it. I'm just like I just want to cycle through all of these cards because I want to find a treasure cruise. I think that's the best way with it for us to win here. Unfortunately, we did not find a treasure cruise or even a creature. This is incredibly discouraging. I assume our opponent is going to cast Dig Through Time. If he does, I think I'll just concede. I don't think we can win. We can realistically win this game at that point. Yeah, that's definitely good enough for our opponent, unless they're astronomically unlucky. We're not getting out of that. Okay, so sideboarding. I think we want all the counter magic and none of the fiery impulses. And I think roast is okay too because of Kalidus. Maybe just two roast. I'm not sure if our opponent has Jace. I'm gonna board out Temur Battle Rage again, and well, actually slip. Slip seems worse than expedite. And oh, I want the Painful Truths for sure as well. I guess Virulent Plague deals with Kalidus tokens, which is kind of cute. No, that's probably too cute. All right, this looks like a reasonable deck to submit. I'm not sure. We might be overboarding here, but I'm gonna try it like this. All right, here we are for game two. We get to go first. Yep, this hand looks good. I guess we'll fetch. I guess we fetch the blue black land here and then just fetch a mountain with this. And that leaves us with a land in hand still in case we draw insight and using the most possible number of fetches, which is a thing we want to do when we have treasure cruise. This definitely feels like the kind of hand that can power through some removal, so that's nice. Ugh. Duress has been really, really hard for us to beat. I feel like we're really all in on these treasure cruises, and Duress is just a huge beating. I think I'm gonna upkeep Fire off of Titan Strength here. We took Roast. Interesting. Well, that makes me even more likely to want a Titan Strength then, because I think we're very likely to cast Cruise soon. So that implies to me that he has a Kalidus, which Disdainful Stroke is good against. We're gonna have four cards in the graveyard, so we will be declining to cast our Cruise next turn, but I think that's okay to have the out on Kalidus, because that card will just eat us alive otherwise. Sure, man down. It's actually not too bad for us. Ooh, Abbott's a great draw. Although it's going to be kind of awkward when we just don't cast whatever we hit. Yeah, do we want to cast this Abbott? Probably not if it involves our opponent resolving a Kalidus. Doesn't seem worth it. And then we get to cast a 2-mana Treasure Cruise next turn. Kind of surprised, like it felt kind of bad there to just pass with the mana up because it seemed so obvious that we would have something, but he just went for it anyway. Well, unfortunately this land doesn't actually cast Swift Spear because we already have our Smoldering Marsh, so I think it's better to hold it in case we draw Magmetic Insight. Is this another Radiant Flames? Yeah, that's pretty annoying. I guess he's at 8. We could definitely get there. Okay, Titan Strength is pretty good, I suppose. I think I'm just gonna play one Swift Spear and attack with it, and then next turn we can play the other Swift Spear. Opponent is now at 6. I guess he gets to cast Dig here, which is really bad for us. Oh, that's not quite a dig. Let's see. So if he has Chandra, do we still win? I'm not sure. This looks like another Kalidus. Sure. Plus Fiery Impulse on our guy. Well, we'll save our guy because we really don't want to give him a token, and hopefully we can find a good spell off of this. Painful Truth definitely qualifies as a good spell. So now we can go Swift Spear, Painful Truths. That actually leaves us kind of unlikely to be able to. Well, I guess if we draw into Treasure Cruise, it's good. We could also just cast Painful Truths by itself, and then it's very likely he'll have to block our Swift Spear. I actually think I like that better. That worked out awful. Guess we'll just play our guy and pass and hope that we don't lose. Basically, we needed to draw any spell we could cast for one mana, or for one or two mana off that Painful Truths for it to work out well. So there's Murderous Cut, and then we get mauled by a zombie, or a vampire, I should say. We definitely still have outs to win this game. That is really bad. I'm going to fetch now because I think we're going to fetch anyway. Cast this Painful Truths. Okay, Swift Spear. Cruise. I guess we don't have all the one mana business in our deck, so it's less likely that this will work. Yeah, now we have to leave a blocker back. I guess I'll just attack for three. He'll probably block and then sack it to Kalidus. I think that's what he should do. And we just don't have a good next turn. He's going to gain five life. Ugh. And we don't have any spells. So I'm going to not block here because I think that gives us the best chance to win. If he has a removal spell, he just kills us, but that's fine. Okay. Painful Truths is actually pretty good for us. It gives us, or at least it gives us a much more realistic chance at winning this game. That's so bad. Magmatic Insight. Blah. Yep, we lose. Well, this is not going very well. I guess we'll play one more round and see how that goes. So far, I feel like I've been flooded a lot and that our spells haven't been quite high enough impact. Like, we get to cast a lot of them, but they haven't quite done enough.